Hello everyone, I am Durgesh Sahni and we are going to create new series of video tutorials for Laravel. So in this whole series of tutorials, we are going to understand what is Laravel and how to perform CRUD operation on MySQL database by using Laravel framework. Okay, so this is the first session in which we are going to see how to set up Laravel on your local machine. So let's start now. So first, what is Laravel? So Laravel is a free open source PHP web framework which is intended for web application development, and it follows the model view controller MVC patterns. Okay, so here I'm on the laravel.com, which is official site of Laravel, and go to the documentation. Now its latest version is 5.7 that we are going to install. Here they have given the steps how you can install it. So for installing Laravel, you should have Composer. And if you don't know about Composer, Composer is a dependency manager for PHP. So it will take care of all the dependencies. And from here, you can go and read more about it. And for downloading, if you want to install it on Windows, simply go and install, download this exe file and just install it. It will be very easy to install you. And if you're on other systems, you can just copy and paste these things and it will install Composer for you. Once it is done, open the command prompt, and if you type Composer, it will print all the available commands and this Composer. Okay. Now if it is installed, then there are two ways you can create a project. First one is you can install this Laravel globally, and then later you can just simply say Laravel new and then project name. It will create a project for you. A second way is simply by using a Composer create project and then again Laravel project name. Okay, so this is how you can create. So I'm just going to copy this and install this Composer Laravel globally so that I can use it number of times. See, here I'm going to install it. So till the time it is installing, let me show you one more thing. See, if you want to use this Composer globally, in that case, you should have one settings. See here, you can see this Composer vendor bin. This should be set it into your path variable, which is environment variable for on Windows. So if you go to the systems properties, then you will find advanced setting, advanced system settings. Okay, and there you will see this environment variables. Just click on that and then you will see this path. Just edit it. Okay, so here you can see I already have added this Composer vendor bin directory. Okay, so if you do this, then only you will be able to access Composer command on command prompt anywhere in your system. Okay, and as I want to use PHP in command prompt, so for that I have added this path over here, C, XAMPP and PHP. So I'm using this XAMPP control panel where I'm managing my all the things like Apache, MySQL and everything. So I've just added this XAMPP PHP and XAMPP MySQL bin. So I can access PHP command and MySQL command in command prompt. So you have to do these things. You have to set the path variables into your environment variables. Okay, these three things. Now I hope it is installed. Yeah, so Laravel is installed now. Now if you want to create a project, so for me, it is my working directory is on D drive. So let's move to the D drive and CD tutorials, and here I want to create the project. So see Laravel new and project name. So I'm just going to say Laravel new and project name is car. Enter. So it will download all the dependencies and it will create a project for us. So it will take some time. Let's understand some other stuffs till the time. See, it have this artisan command which is used to, I'll show you it in later once it is installed. There are number of commands you can use at command prompt, and it will create it's a helper for you. It will create a model for you, it will create controller migrations and everything. So one simple example is if you use this, so if you don't have any, if you have installed PHP and you want to use the built-in server, then you can simply say PHP artisan serve, and at this URL you can access your project. Okay, the next thing is, so once it is installed, I'll show you this. There is a public folder, and inside there you'll find index.php, which is the this will be the front controller for all the HTTP request entering your applications. So yeah, it's installing now. Almost it's going to install 72 packages. So let's wait for some time. Okay. So it's almost downloaded now. Okay. So here you can see we have created this car project, and here we have number of folders and files. We'll understand everything one by one when we come across that scenario. Okay, now see, the first thing is this public and this index.php. So whenever your any request come to your applications, that comes to this part of this things, and from here it will get served. So see, for us, I'm just going to say tutorials/car, enter. There you'll see public folder, and here you can see this is the Laravel. It is installed successfully and you can run your applications. Okay, so how it is rendering, let's understand that thing. Here you can see there is a routes folder, and inside it there is a number of routes, like for API this is the file, for web applications this is web.php file, and here you can see here we can register the root. So if any GET request is coming, okay, on our server, render this welcome file. And now what is welcome? If you go to the resource view, and here you'll find welcome.blade.php, okay, and this is Laravel documentation and all the things are printing. So if you say hello Laravel and just refresh this page, you can see hello Laravel, right? So all the and see, you can notice welcome.blade.php. So what is Blade? Blade is a default template engine of Laravel. Okay, so we'll see it later in detail. Now all your JS file or SAS file, LESS file will be over here. You can create all the TPLs, whenever you create any view, that should go into the view folder. Okay, and here you can register the route, and whatever the controllers you want to create, that should go into this app HTTP and here controller. Okay, so we'll understand everything one by one. So in this session we have learned how to install Laravel in your local machine. In the next session I'll show you some more stuff which is related to our tutorials, like database, how to configure database and how to connect with database, all the stuffs. Okay, so thank you very much guys for watching. If you like my videos, please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.